Emerald's birthday celebrations had begun in confusion and disarray. She cast about her for something sensible to say, something that would reassure her mother and friends that an hospitable timetable would be re-established, and was about to suggest the library and tea when she halted, arrested in movement like a musical statue. She was obeying a prompt, an instinct left over perhaps from an earlier time, the instinct that stops a mouse in its short-sighted tracks when a cat is watching from a chair, that makes a dog lying by the fire tremble of a sudden and whimper when there's no one to see. And as she stopped, there came of a sudden a hard gust of wind behind her, striking her through her dress, forcefully blowing all thoughts of convention from her mind. The heavy front door was closed, but the chill struck Emerald's back, finding its way through the jamb and hinges, through the solid wood itself, it seemed, as a cold wave will sometimes catch one as one leaves the sea and knock the breath from the body. She walked to the door, opened it, and looked out into the squally air. Shivering, looking away to her right, far down the drive, she strained her eyes at the emerging vision. A small group of people was emerging from the gloom of the drive onto the gravel, slowly and all together. Clovis gave a low whistle.
"My word,"
he said.
"They're here."